my future that grim? You mentioned a child. I don't believe in this stuff, but it's always a little scary, whatever you think of it.
Dish that is better than roast chicken, and that duck meets the potatoes. Excellent. It's wunderbar. The most difficult part is for catching the little duck, I show you.
We have a strong cold front moving our way, coming down from Canada, bringing with it heavy snow and very windy conditions all down the coastal region. The temperatures are several degrees below normal for this time of year. Let's take a look at the satellite view of this front.
Expose all she knows. Normally, I don't like leaving Sam home alone, especially now. But this bookmark had me intrigued. I had a gut feeling that I was holding the key that would identify our killer. I felt like I was closing in on him, and I wasn't about to go home to sleep until I figured out what this paper meant. Nothing but stock quotes. How can anyone possibly decipher these things? Wait a minute. That's it. I gotta call Carla right away. It's a list of stock quotes, Carla. Our bookmark was printed in a bank.
Of course. It's so obvious. How'd you figure that out?
I opened the paper to the stock quotes page, and it was right under my nose the whole time. Now we just have to figure out which bank printed it.
Can you fax me the bookmark? I think I have an idea. I'll call you right back.
to expose all she knows. You play like tease, just a curve with featherweight curves. To expose all she knows, you play like tease, you're gonna leave
Sorry to bother you, Tommy.
No problem. I wasn't ready for bed yet anyway. What can I do for you?
It's about one of my investigations. I thought maybe you could help me with a question I have. I was wondering, is there a way to identify a bank from a list of stock quotes that they've printed?
Normally, yeah. Banks always use watermarked paper, which shows the bank's ID code.
The ID code is printed on a watermark? All right, I'll check our document to see. Thanks, Tommy. Good night.
Night, Carla.
Yeah?
Our bookmark should be watermarked with the bank's ID code.
I'll check it out and call you right back.
I found it.
Tyler?
I've got the code. You should have no trouble identifying which bank it corresponds to.
This time we've got our killer. I think I'll pay a little visit to the bank tomorrow.
You want me to go?
Okay, you go. We'll meet afterwards at the station and go over it all. See you tomorrow, Tyler.
See you tomorrow.
Lucas Kane.
Master Noctilan Katanekle Kotitlan Alitan Western Apani Bali Vitan Kailon.
Lucas's terrifying story haunted me all night long. I had to see him, to talk to him. I had to find out what Agatha had told him. I wanted to look my brother in the eye and hear the truth. I'd never been to his apartment before, and it took me some time to find it. Lucas Kane. That's it. Lucas? Lucas, open the door! Lucas! I could swear that I heard a scream coming from inside. The doorman said Lucas was at home, but he isn't opening. Lucas is in danger. I've got no other choice. Lucas! Oh my God! Lucas, for God's sake, have you lost your mind? What's come over you?
The walls were blown away, and the wind, the tempest, I...
Why did you do this, Lucas? Why?
Somebody tried to kill me.
For heaven's sake, Lucas, there's no one else here but you and I. You were all alone when I arrived. All alone, Lucas.
What's happening to me, Marcus? I don't know what's happening.
It'll be all right, Lucas. Everything will be fine. I'm gonna help you. You'll see.
I finally convinced Marcus to let me go out. I'd slept most of the day, and he'd stayed to watch over me. I needed to get out and get back in touch with reality. My physical condition was deteriorating rapidly. My mental state wasn't much better. I could feel myself slipping away. I knew that it wouldn't be long before I lost it.
Hello, Detective Theodore Miles, New York Police.
The police? They found me. Late for me to think about running. A torn piece of computer paper. I think I must have used it for a bookmark. Better try to hide this.
Detective Tyler Miles, New York Police. Are you Lucas Kane? I've just got a couple of questions for you.
It's just that I don't really see how I could be of any help to you.
Well, it's worth a try. It won't take very long.
What do you want to know?
Could you confirm that this list came from here at the bank? Well, this could have come from almost anywhere, really.
Yo, you better take a closer look. Your bank's ID code is on the watermark. That means it must have come from here, right?
I wasn't paying attention. Obviously, this paper was printed out from here.
Is there a way to establish where it was printed from? The manager already filled me in, but maybe we can learn something more.
Difficult to say. Everybody who works at the bank has access to this paper, you know.
Your manager told me that this kind of paper was only used by stock buyers to print out their quotes.
That's correct. But there are at least 100 buyers here, so how do we know which one it is?
Yo, this guy seems kind of whack, like he's hiding something. Is there a problem, Mr. Kane?
Huh? No, sorry.
Is there a way to determine where this particular document was printed out?
No, not really. Our printers don't leave any identifiable marks.
A witness helped us make a composite photo of the suspect. Would you mind taking a look at it for us? You all right, sir?
Yes, I'm fine.
I feel tense. I've got to keep cool.
This remind you of anyone?
Hey, this looks like a lot of people I know. Could even be me.
Yeah, you're right. These composite photos can be a little vague. Yo, this is weird. The composite looks just like this guy right here. Sir, are you sure that you're all right?
I thought that... Excuse me.
Have you noticed anything unusual here at the bank lately? They already told me about what happened to this guy yesterday. I wonder if he's going to mention it.
Yes, actually, I'm susceptible to epileptic seizures. They're fairly rare, but they can be violent. In fact, I had one yesterday, and I'm afraid I put on quite a show. But that's about the only unusual thing that's happened here recently.
That's weird. His forearms are bandaged. I wonder what happened to him. Did something happen to your arms?
Are my arms part of your investigation?
No, man, of course not. I was just curious, that's all. Hey, is that you in the picture with the priest? Is he a friend of yours? That priest looks a lot like him. Maybe a member of his family?
That's my brother, Marcus.
Sir, are you sure you're feeling all right? You don't look so good.
I might have a little cold.
This guy seems to be mentally unstable. I think he might be our man, but I gotta be sure. Do you have access to this type of paper, Mr. Kane?
Yes, of course. I'm in charge of computer maintenance, so I have access to every type of paper we use. This list could even have been printed out on my printer, if that's what you want to know.
Can you tell me where you were on the night of January 26th? Look, I'm sick of all these stupid questions. If you're going to accuse me of something, just do it and get it over with.
Pardon me, these are just routine questions, sir.
I'm not feeling very well. I'm just going to go and splash some water on my face.
You go right ahead. I'll wait for you here. He's acting so strangely. I better take a quick look inside his desk before he gets back. His pen. There ought to be some fingerprints on it. That'll make it easy to see if this is our man. Feeling better?
Yes, thanks.
Well, I don't have any more questions. I'll let you get back to work. Thank you for your cooperation, sir. What's up? Anybody home?
Tyler? I didn't expect you so soon. Be a good boy and preheat the oven. Oh, and pour us a couple of glasses of champagne from the fridge. I'll be out in a minute.
Sam is holed up in the bedroom. Well, since I got no idea what's going on, I might as well do what she wants.
Did you get the oven going and pour the champagne?
Yeah, I'm on it right now.
Hello, Detective Miles. Do you know what day it is today?
Well, we already had Christmas, so 4th of July? No, that's summer. No, you got me.
Tyler.
Okay, babe. It's been exactly 2 years since I met the woman of my dreams.
You want to put some music on? I feel like dancing.
Thank you. and time again. This time I'm gonna win. But another fight, things ain't right. I'm losing again. Takes a fool to lose twice. Start all over again. Think I better let it go. Looks like another love TKO. Oh, oh, oh. Think I better let it go. What you think about it, girl? Oh, yeah. Try to take control of the love, love took control of me. Cause I lose all thoughts, sense of time, have a change of mind. Taking the bumps and the bruises of all the things of a people.
Tyler gave me a full report on what happened at Nazer and Jones. He emphasized that one of the employees was behaving strangely, a guy named Lucas Kane. Now, I had all the pieces of the puzzle. I just needed to put them all together to find our murderer. On my desk lay all the information from Nazer and Jones. On Tyler's desk, the clues from the restaurant. The identity of the killer was here somewhere. It's completely idiotic, but it helps me think. Detective Valenti.
Hi, Carla. It's Garrett. I called to tell you that I sent you the results of the testing we did on the prints on that pen. They should already be in your email.
Perfect. Thanks, Garrett. I'll take a look right away.
The taxi company should have sent you a list of taxi destinations from the same street as the diner the night of the murder. It should be on the fax in your office.
Thanks. Bye, Garrett.
Bye, Carla.
Thank you.
Lucas Kane's fingerprints. The killer's prints found on the murder weapon. No doubt about it, the prints from the restaurant and the pen come from the same person. I've got my first link. I'll need another in order to establish proof that Kane is our man. Come in.
Oh, hi, Carla. I saw the light was on, so I thought I'd, come in and say hello.
Nice to see you, Martin. It's calmer here at night. It helps me think a little clearer.
Carla, this has been bothering me for a while. I need to talk to you. You see, I saw the killer from the restaurant. He saved a kid who was drowning in Central Park. The kid would have died without him. I was there when it happened. And it's stupid, but I just couldn't bring myself to arrest him after that. I just figured he'd earned a break. I'm really sorry.
Oh, don't feel too bad about it, Martin. I might have done the same thing in your place.
Well, I'll be around for at least another hour. Damn reports to type up. Come and see me if you need some company.
Catch you later, Martin. Torn piece of stuck list paper that the killer used as a bookmark. No connection between those two elements. List of taxi destinations on the night of the murder. If the killer left the scene in a taxi, his address might be here. No, that doesn't work. List of employees at Nacer and Jones. We have the name, address, and photo of everyone who works at the bank. Hey, here's Kane's file. Is he our man? I've seen this address before. Of course! The night of the murder, someone took a taxi to Kane's house. This time, there's no reasonable doubt. Lucas Kane is the restaurant killer. I've got to tell Tyler right away. Don't answer it, lover.
Sorry, babe. I need to answer it. It might be important.
Tyler, no!
Hello?
We got him, Tyler.
I'm on my way.
Tyler, I'm warning you. If you leave me now, I will never forgive you.
I won't be long, babe. Just sip some champagne and I'll be right back before you know it. I'm sorry, Sam, but this is really important.
What about me? I'm not important? Tyler!
The noose is tightening. The police are closing in on me. They'll be back, and next time, they'll take me in. Agatha was my last chance. She's the only one who seems to understand what's happening to me. I just hope this time she'll give me some answers.